Circles. Today, we will discuss circles and its related terms. Friends, we see many round objects around us and use them. For example, wheels, bangles, coins, etc. And we have read in previous classes how to create this type of shape. Let us repeat this once. Take a paper and fix a pencil in a compass. Now, position its pointed end at one point. Keep its other arm at a steady distance and move it around in a circle once. Friends, you're well acquainted with the shape made on this paper. Yes, this round figure is called a circle. Based on its design, we can define the circle thus. A circle is a group of points on a plane that lie at a constant distance from a stationary point on the plane. We call the stationary point the center of this circle. Point O is the center of this circle, and we call this constant distance as the radius of the circle. Line segment OA is the radius of this circle. We also define it as the line segment joining the center to any point of the circle is called the radius. Friends, radius is used in two ways. First, as a line segment, such as the line segment OA here, and second, as the length of the line segment OA. Friends, there are countless points on the circle. So can you tell how many radii we can draw in a circle? You can pause the video and think of the answer. Yes, friends. In a circle, we can draw infinite number of radii. But all will have the same length. Friends, the circle divides the plane on which it is situated into three parts. First is the part that is inside the circle and is called interior. Second is the circle itself. And third is the part that is outside the circle, which is called exterior. The circle and its interior, that is, the inner part, together form a circular region. Friends, suppose we join any two points lying on this circle like this, then what will we call this line segment? Yes, we call it a chord. But if a chord is made in such a way that it goes through the center of the circle, then we call such chord a diameter. Here line segment PS is the diameter of the circle. Friends, look at this diameter PS carefully. It is made up of two radii. That is, the length of the diameter is twice the radius. If we take two points on a circle like this, then the part between these two points is called an arc. Friends, there are two parts here. The small part is called minor arc. And the large part is called major arc. That is, AB is the minor arc, which we write like this. And AXB is the major arc, where X is the point between them. Friends, can you guess when will these two arcs be equal? You can also pause the video to think about the answer. Yes, when both these points are the end points of the diameter of this circle, then the two arcs will become equal. Each arc thus formed is called a semicircle. Friends, the length of the entire circle is called its circumference. And the region between a chord and either of its arcs is called a segment of the circle. You can see that we got two types of segments of circle. We call the large part as major segment and the small part as minor segment. Friends, in a circle, if two radii are made in this way, then the area between these radii and the arc is called sector. This large part is major sector and small part is minor sector. But when both these arcs become equal, then both the segments and both the sectors become equal. Now, what will we call this? Yes, friends, this is a semicircle. And this region is called the semicircular region. Friends, that's all in this session. We discuss circle and its related terms. See you in the next video with some questions related to this. Thank you.